corporate social responsibility is the impact that a company has on people, on communities, and on the planet. In the 1990s, we started to realize that companies, while they can do great things, they can lift generations out of poverty, and they can provide products and services that contribute to an improved quality of life for all of us, they can also have really harmful impacts on people. Companies have globalized supply chains, and we've realized that we don't always understand the impacts that those supply chains have. We don't have a good line of sight into the working conditions, into those factories. We don't have a good line of sight into what's happening to communities where we pull up resources, where we source raw materials. And that's when the international community started to think, okay, we need some standards. So the United Nations saw a need to clarify what are corporate responsibilities for human rights and created a special representative to bring clarity to this debate, to clarify businesses' responsibilities for human rights. And what has been interesting to see about that process is not just that now the UN has a statement on businesses' responsibilities for the first time, but actually companies are starting to incorporate the recommendations of the guiding principles because they're useful and they're practical. So I think that we actually get into a lot of trouble when we ask companies to do things that is not in their interest, because then when there's a financial downturn, when there's a cyclical downturn, that stuff goes away. So what I want to see is corporate social responsibility embedded in the core business of a company, because then it can't go away. It's essential. It's essential to risk mitigation. It's essential to brand. It's essential to reputation. It can't go away. It has to be embedded. And that's where I want to see corporate social responsibility end up.